Hi, my name is Wayne Seeto. I'm Master Instructor Trainer for Merrithew. Today I have David Taylor helping with some few exercises for rotator cuff. He's also an Instructor Trainer for Merrithew. So today we've seen in some previous exercises how we've looked at the helotrainer as a stabilizer of our base, which is our scapula, and then we integrated our base, our scapula, with some torso stabilization as well as some co-contraction through the shoulder. Okay, so today what we're going to do is that now we're going to be looking at the shoulder joint itself with some rotator cuff stimulating exercises. It's a little bit of a high level, so it should be at the appropriate stage. So the first thing we're going to have a look at is that we're going to come into a position called the handles down position. So you can see in the handles down position that the ball surface is unstable, but the halo trainer actually stabilizes the ball. So you get a lot more feedback into your torso. So if David, for instance, is rotated to one side, he's going to feel a lot more pressure from the ball. So he can add a self-correction. So it can be more of a reactive kind of neuromuscular stimulation. Okay, so what's nice about this position here is that oftentimes with rotator cuff, posturally you often see that the shoulder goes into a protracted state, okay, and the thorax into a flex state, okay. So by working through the retractors of the scapula as well as through the extensors of the thorax, we have a postural control component. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add, okay, an accessory load. So we're going to add some toning balls to this exercise, okay, and we're going to position the arms so that we're in an abductor position. Now you're going to see that this is a very challenged position for the shoulder. It's the apprehensive position for the shoulder. So again, you don't want to see any sort of anterior instability in the shoulder. You can modify the position of the arms, okay, as appropriate to the control of the head of the humerus. But David's going to show, he doesn't have any injuries, so he's going to show the most challenged position for the rotator cuff as well as through the anterior shoulder. Okay, so this is called ball drop. Okay, so in the ball drop, we're going to see that David's going to let the ball go, but he's going to catch it before it touches the ball, the ground, sorry. The goal is to see whether he can catch the ball, okay, and you want to see if he can let it drop for as long as possible without it falling onto the floor. So it requires a lot of reactive components happening through the shoulder. You're going to see that it's a lot of eccentric work through the rotator cuff in order for you to try to catch that ball. Okay, so there's that wind up and then that eccentric control. Okay, once we've got the hang of that, David can go into more concentric work through the rotator cuff. So he can do what we call an up catch of the ball. So he's going to throw the ball up and catch it. Good, and throw the ball up. So that's a little bit more of a concentric focus through the rotator cuff, especially through the external rotators. Okay, and then we want to go into progression where he becomes a little bit more reactive through the whole body, okay? So then we're going to go into just some throwing tasks, some perturbation type tasks, okay? So again, initially you want to start off, okay, is he maintaining his core control on the halo frame? Okay, and then eventually you want to start to speed things up. Okay, and then get him to reach out of his base of support, okay? So then a lot more, okay, challenge through the body. Good. So I hope you have some fun with that, and thanks for joining me.